This is a very special night. We gather to remember and draw close to Jesus on this night, in which he gave us the gift of Holy Communion as he celebrated Passover with his closest followers. He washed his friends' feet, shared parting words of instruction, prayed in the garden, and was betrayed. In the early church, a vigil was held by Christians from Thursday until Easter morning as they prayed and relived the events of that week as recorded in Scripture. Tonight, we will walk together the path that Jesus walked on that Thursday. Let us pray. Precious Lord, we come tonight, our hearts open, to listen to your words and share in your journey. Draw us closer to your loving heart, for we gather and pray in your name. Amen. And now, if you'll stand and sing together, Lead Me to Calvary, verses 1, 2, and 4. King of my life, I crown thee now, thine shall the glory be. Lest I forget thy crown-crowned brow, lead me to Calvary. Lest I forget Gethsemane, lest I forget thine agony, lest I forget thy love for me, lead me to Calvary. Show me the tomb where thou wast laid, tenderly mourned and wept. Angels in robes of light arrayed guarded thee while thou slept. Lest I forget Gethsemane, lest I forget seated. And now we join in a prayer of confession. My sisters and brothers, Christ shows us his love by becoming a humble servant. Let us draw near to God and confess our sin in the truth of God's Spirit. Most merciful God, we confess that often our spirit has not been that of Christ. Instead of being humble and loving, we are often proud and selfish. Forgive us where we have failed to love one another as he loves us. Forgive us for the times when we have pledged loyalty to him with our lips and then betrayed, deserted, or denied him. Wash us clean with your love poured out. Draw us closer to Jesus and to one another as we gather at the Last Supper. And by your Spirit, make us faithful in every time of trial. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Who is in a position to condemn? Only Christ. But Christ suffered and died for us, was raised from the dead, and ascended on high for us, and continues to pray for us. believe the good news. In the name of Jesus Christ, you are forgiven. Glory to God. Amen. And now we invite Ernest to come up and do our first reading this evening.
Good evening, everyone. Mark 14, verse 12 to 16. The Passover with the disciples. On the first day of the unleavened bread, when the Passover lamb is sacrificed, his disciples said to him, "Where do you want to go and make the preparations for you to eat the Passover?" So he sent two of his disciples, saying to them, "Go into the city, and a man carrying a jar of water will meet you. Follow him. And wherever he enters, say to the owner of the house, 'The teacher asks, where is my guest room where I may eat the Passover with my disciples?' He said, 'Show you a large room upstairs, furnished and ready. Make preparations for us there.' So the disciples set out and went to the city and found everything as he had told them, and they prepared the Passover meal." John 13, 1 to 17. Jesus washes disciples' feet. Now, before the festival of the Passover, Jesus knew that his hour had come to depart from the world and go to the Father. Having loved his own who were in the world, he loved them to the end. The devil had already decided that Judas, son of Simon Iscariot, would betray Jesus. And during supper, Jesus, knowing that the Father had given all things into the hands that he had come from God and was going to God, got up from supper, took off his outer robe, and tied a towel around himself. Then he poured water into the basin and began to wash the disciples' feet and to wipe them with the towel that he had tied around him. He came to Simon Peter, who said to him, "Lord, are you going to wash my feet?" Jesus answered, "You do not know now what I am doing, but later you will understand." Peter said to him, "You will never wash my feet." Jesus answered, "Unless I wash you, you have no share with me." Simon Peter said to him, "Lord, not my feet only, but also my hands and my head." Jesus said to him, "One who has bathed does not need to wash except for feet, but is entirely clean. And you are clean, though not all of you." For he knew who was to betray him. For this reason, he said, "Not all of you are clean." After he had washed their feet, had put on his robe, and had reclined again, he said to them, "Do you know what I have done to you? You call me teacher and Lord, and you are right, for that is what I am. So if your Lord and teacher have washed your feet, you also ought to wash one another's feet. For I have set you an example that you also should do as I have done. Very truly, I tell you, slaves are not greater than their master, nor are messengers greater than the one who sent them. If you know these things, you are blessed if you do them." John 13, 33 to 35. "Little children, I am with you only a a little longer. You will look for me, and as I said to the Jews, so now I say to you, where I am going, you cannot come. I give you a new commandment that you love one another, just as I have loved you. You also should love one another. By this, everyone will know that you are my disciples, if you love one another. This is the word of God.
We'll now join in together on What Wondrous Love Is This, number 292. And we'll do the first verse and the third verse. We can stand if you'd like to. As we come to the table now, we have a reading from Mark 14, verses 17 through 25. When it was evening, he came with the 12. And when they had taken their places and were eating, Jesus said, "Truly I tell you, one of you will betray me, one who is eating with me." They began to be distressed and to say to him one after another, "Surely not I." He said to them, "It is one of the 12, one who is dipping bread into the bowl with me. For the Son of Man goes as it is written of him, but woe to that one by whom the Son of Man is betrayed. It would have been better for that one not to have been born." While they were eating, he took a loaf of bread, and after blessing it, he broke it and gave it to them. And he said, "Take, this is my body." Then he took a cup, and after giving thanks, he gave it to them, and all of them drank from it. He said to them, "This is my blood of the covenant, which is poured out for many. Truly, I tell you, I will never again drink of the fruit of the vine until that day when I drink it new in the kingdom of God." And so now we gather and we share this holy meal together, just as the disciples did on this night. And for practical purposes here, we have gluten-free elements. We also have elements in a cup if you would prefer to do that. And so Mary, if you'll come and assist. If you would like to engage in hand washing before you come forward. We have the ceremonial hand sanitizer for you to use. Mary, this is the body of Christ given for you, and the blood of Christ shed for you.
This is the body of Christ given for you.
Amen.
And the blood of Christ shed for you.
Amen. All are invited to the table. Let us pray. Gracious and loving God, we thank you for this holy mystery. We thank you for the love that we celebrate tonight and what you have done for us. We ponder with thankful hearts, and we pray a prayer of thanksgiving for all that will be renewed. We thank you and we praise you in Jesus' name. Amen.
Mark 14, 26 through 31. When they had sung the hymn, they went out to the Mount of Olives, and Jesus said to them, "You will all fall away, for it is written, 'I will strike the shepherd, and the sheep will be scattered.' But after I am raised up, I will go before you to Galilee." Peter said to him, "Even though all fall away, I will not." Jesus said to him, "Truly, I tell you, this day, this very night, before the cock crows twice, you will deny me three times." But he said vehemently, "Even though I must die with you, I will not deny you." And all of them said the same. It's the word of God for the people of God.
And pray.
Mark 14:32-42. They went to a place called Gethsemane, and he said to his disciples, "Sit here while I pray." He took with him Peter and James and John, and began to be distressed and agitated. He said to them, "My soul is deeply grieved, even to death. Remain here and keep awake." And going a little farther, he threw himself on the ground and prayed that if it were possible, the hour might pass from him. He said, "Abba, Father, for you all things are possible. Remove this cup from me, yet not what I want, but what you want." He came and found them sleeping. And he said to Peter, "Simon, are you asleep? Could you not keep awake for 1 hour? Keep awake and pray that you may not come into the time of trial. The spirit indeed is willing, but the flesh is weak." And again he went away and prayed, saying the same words. And once more he came and found them sleeping, for their eyes were very heavy, and they did not know what to say to him. He came a third time and said to them, "Are you still sleeping and taking your rest? Enough! The hour has come. The Son of Man is betrayed into the hands of sinners. Get up. Let us be going. Look, my betrayer is at hand." The word of God for the people of God.
Stay with me. Remain here with me. Watch and pray.
Betrayal and arrest of Jesus. Immediately while he was still speaking, Judas, one of the 12, arrived, and with him there was a crowd with swords and clubs from the chief priests, the scribes, and the elders. Now the betrayer had given them a sign, saying, "The one I will kiss is the man. Arrest him and lead him away under guard." So when he came, he went up to him at once and said, "Rabbi," and kissed him. Then they laid hands on him and arrested him. But one of those who stood near drew his sword and struck the slave of the high priest, cutting off his ear. Then Jesus said to them, "Have you come out with swords and clubs to arrest me as though I were a rebel? Day after day I was with you in the temple, teaching, and you did not arrest me. But let the scriptures be fulfilled." All of them deserted him and fled. The word of God.
Stay with me, remain here with me, watch and pray, watch and pray.
Mark 14:53-65.
Jesus before the council. They took Jesus to the high priest, and all the chief priests, the elders, and the scribes were assembled. Peter had followed him at a distance, right into the courtyard of the high priest, and he was sitting with the guards, warming himself at the fire. Now the chief priests and the whole council were looking for testimony against Jesus to put him to death, but they found none, for many gave false testimony against him, and their testimony did not agree. Some stood up and gave false testimony against him, saying, "We heard him say, 'I will destroy this temple that is made with hands, and in 3 days I will build another not made with hands.' But even on this point, their testimony did not agree. Then the high priest stood up before them and asked Jesus, 'Have you no answer? What is it that they testify against you?' But he was silent and did not answer. Again, the high priest asked him, 'Are you the Messiah, the Son of the Blessed One?' Jesus said, 'I am, and you will see the Son of Man seated at the right hand of the power and coming with the clouds of heaven.' Then the high priest tore his clothes and said, 'Why do we still need witnesses? You have heard his blasphemy. What is your decision?' All of them condemned him as deserving death. Some began to spit on him, to blindfold him, and to strike him, saying to people, 'Prophecy.' The guards all took him and beat him." The word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God.
But I have paid my ransom.
We leave now in prayerful silence. Watch and pray. Walk with Jesus to the cross and prepare your hearts for Easter. Our next service will be tomorrow at noon for our Good Friday service.